Hi, I'm Marge Easley with the League of Women Voters. The League is a nonpartisan organization that has provided voters with unbiased election information since 1920. We've invited candidates to engage in conversations about important issues. Welcome to our Video Voters Guide, and welcome to Suzanne Bonamici, candidate for U.S. Representative District 1. Nice to have you here.
Thank you. Great to be back, Marge.
Thank you. You are running for re-election now. How long have you been serving?
Yes, since the beginning of 2012, when I was honored to be elected in a special election. So I served in 2012, was re-elected at the end of 2012, and then again in 2014.
And you're doing it again.
Yes, I am running for re-election.
And so why do you feel it's important at this time? And what are some of your goals and accomplishments that you'd like to tout today?
Thank you. Well, I serve in Congress. It's such an honor to represent this great diverse district, the northwest part of the state of Oregon. And one of the reasons I got involved in public policy and ran for office was because of the potential of public education to give everyone opportunities regardless of background, zip code. And I'm happy to report that we did make progress at the federal level with the rewriting, Leaving Behind, No Child Left Behind. I played a big role in that.
Wonderful.
And we passed the Every Student Succeeds Act, and that focuses more on the true purpose, which is equity, making sure that all students have opportunity, more decisions made at the state and local level, fewer, better assessments, and importantly, more of a focus on well-rounded education. So I was honored to be able to work on that, both on the Education Committee and on the Conference Committee. Got to stand with President Obama when he signed the bill, and now it's being implemented. I'd like to continue to work on that. We also passed the Older Americans Act, and that's something I worked on very hard as well for a couple of years. That's the important federal law that funds programs like Meals on Wheels, senior centers. There's some really important elder abuse provisions in that. I'm proud of that work as well and want to continue to work on those issues.
Right.
But one of the reasons I'm running for re-election, Marge, is because I feel like I just got started working on so many of these important issues like college affordability. Now, I worked my way through community college, college and law school, had a very manageable amount of debt, and that's not what I'm hearing from families today. So college affordability, opening up those options for students. I have a great bipartisan bill to get more students into income-based repayment plans for student loans, and have built a lot of relationships and want to continue that work. And also my work on the science committee is
Let's hear about that. Tell us so what you've been doing there.
The Science, Space, and Technology Committee is a committee with a tremendous amount of potential. Just like the Education Committee, a great committee for this district. We unfortunately have not been able to make a lot of progress addressing the threat of climate change, but in my position as the top Democrat on the Environment Committee, I'm constantly reaching out and raising awareness about the issues that are important in that area, particularly things like ocean acidification and how that's affecting our coastline. I just joined a bipartisan climate solutions caucus, which is great that we have bipartisan support in our caucus, equal number of Democrats and Republicans who understand the threat of climate change. So that is something that I want to continue working on as well.
Good.
And making progress in that
area. Well, I wanted to ask you because the perception, the public perception, is that Congress is fairly dysfunctional, that not able to address the issues that need to be addressed because of the extreme partisanship that's going on. Do you find that to be the case, and what are you going to be doing to counteract that?
Thank you, Marge. Appreciate that question. And if you only watched particular news sources, you would think that that was the case. There is that partisan perception of people. From day one, from my time in Congress, I made a commitment to build relationships, have friends across the aisle, and have worked with very conservative members of Congress. If you start with the understanding, as I do, that everybody wants the same thing. We all want good jobs, we want safety, we want a clean planet, we want good schools, strong economy. we have different ideas about how to accomplish those things, but if you start with that understanding that everybody is after the same goal and form relationships, you can get more done. And I have partnered, for example, with some very conservative members on issues like my Tsunami Warning Education Research Act, which passed the House, and the Senate. We're trying to get it back through the House, and also on a bill to improve weather forecasting. I've found common ground with people. And I find that it's being respectful is something that helps.
Good.
And
maybe
and
we just
we
need
make
to change,
more progress.
Change the climate change name so that it doesn't become that divisive issue. And I think that we need to work harder on tackling that.
Absolutely. Well, we have the Climate Solutions Caucus, which I'm very
Good.
Excited about joining.
Good. I like that term. Right now, also, there's some health care issues. A number of insurance companies have pulled out of the Affordable Care Act. And so tell us what your goals are for that.
Sure. And I was very concerned about anything that might happen that reduces mm-hmm. access to affordable health care. And the Affordable Care Act passed before my time in Congress, but I did work on health care issues when I was in the state legislature as well. I understand that it's a critical importance for people in this country to have access to affordable health care. And the Affordable Care Act has helped ensure millions of people across this country. Are we done with the work there? Absolutely not. But the benefits from things like not having a ban on pre-existing conditions, allowing young people to stay on their parents' policy longer, those things have helped increase coverage. We do have work to do to make sure that people have that access and that they have that affordability.
Great.
Committed to working on that, again, in a bipartisan way.
And one other issue that's of concern to the League of Women Voters is campaign finance reform.
Absolutely.
And I'd like to hear your thoughts
sure.
on that.
That's a concern to the League of Women Voters, I understand, and to people I speak with across Northwest Oregon.
Bet.
There's no question that our campaign finance system is broken. Citizens United was a terrible opinion. I have done everything I can to show my support for changing that. We can't do that in Congress because it was an interpretation by the Supreme Court of the Constitution, but I'm in favor of amending the Constitution if that's what it takes, making sure that the Supreme Court gets the message that this is not working in our system. And then in the meantime, I'm supporting all of the various disclosure bills to make sure that there is more transparency until we can end that endless flow of unaccountable dollars
right.
through super PACs, which
right.
has been really tough on this country and tough for the system as well.
I agree. Thank you. And one last thing is you have two opponents
yes.
in this race.
Mm-hmm.
And so why should folks continue to elect you to be our representative, and what sets you apart?
Well, thank you, Marge. And I'm not one of these people who always wanted to be a politician. I wanted to be a ballet dancer when I was young and got involved primarily because of education. But I do have experience, not just in the state legislature, but in Congress of actually accomplishing things, building those relationships, breaking down barriers, and finding that common ground to accomplish things for the district. I am also a proponent of passing legislation to improve safety in this community with regard to gun violence. Gun violence prevention is something that does have broad bipartisan support across the district, across the state, and across the country. Unfortunately, there are too many in Congress who don't agree with some very common sense things like universal background checks
right.
that are very consistent with the Second Amendment. So I'm committed to doing what I can to keep communities safe and secure, and that's one step.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much. Well, we have run out of time, so I thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you. It's always a pleasure. Thank you.